Feet, so same drill. I'm gonna jab.
Knee jab
crosses.
I cross and hook.
Or
knee jab and cross.
Cross and uppercut.
Knee jab.
Cross and hook. I'm gonna pull something down and go on top.
Idea.
Pull something out the way so I can hit. So on Monday, we were looking at this combination where we go. Cross, uppercut, left hammer, and then you have a big right hammer down the side. You guys are here on Monday. And the idea of that one is that I get him to put his guard up there, so there's something for me to pull on. If I pull down, I create an opening for my head. So I'm going to use a similar idea here, but inside more of a flurry of a drill. One, two, cross, finish up, pull something down. See how I've made a gap to hit over the top? Cut and pull and hit. And even if you keep the guard there nice and strong, because the guard's up nice and high, you can pull something on there, at least I've made an angle. Whether my hit might not get through, but see, he's pointing away and I'm pointing towards him, so maybe that opens up. Good body shot. Or if we have this opportunity, a good leg kick. Or an escape. So I'm looking to use my left hand hammering effect to move this whole upper body offline. Put a shot in after that. Nice. I can use it to facilitate where I'm trying to go. Nice as well. So jab, cross. Cross, and then either hook or uppercut. Backhand with the left hand, make it open. He jabs, we have cross, he goes cross, and I'm something left hand, he uses his left hand to pull me around, and hit. So what are the possible responses? You go jab, and sit. Close, pick up. I do just moves my arm out of the way, because my body stays here, which made a nice opening. Use all of me here. I'm still covered up, but you see he's moved me offline, so I have to take at least one motion to face him again. So he effectively gets a free shot, whether that's up to the head, or if he's got a body shot, or a leg, or a kick, or an escape, or something, he gets one free go. So monstrously strong, he can't move me. He can now block me from following him while he moves himself. And he effectively creates the same angle. Try it. Mm-hmm. The principle we're kind of using is if I try and get him to not hit me for a second, that's it. Use my left hand here, if I can use that momentum to pull him or pull me or remove his guard, we make that an advantage. Can you try it?
Yep.
Yes, okay. Cross, hook, hammer, right elbow. Push, left knee, push, right kick. Cross, hook, left hammer, right elbow. Push, left knee, push again. Hand holding. Right hand goes straight for that cross. Left hand goes horizontal for the hook. Right hand stays straight for the hammer and stays straight for the downward elbow. Now I'm going to move my pads down, holding for the knee. And the knee here. I'm going to move my pads to the side for the kick. two, three, four. Down to the knee. Side leg. Good?
Yeah.
Cool. Side